Bible says it's whosoever. It takes you to believe it. If you don't believe it, guess what? It ain't gonna be no good for you.
Amen. All right. Amen.
You gonna just, you know, it's a lot of things we hear in the day, in our day. If you don't believe what God said, now Jesus told the Pharisees this, and I like what he said. He said, because you refuse to believe that I am who I say I am, and I came to do what I said I came to do. He said, you're going to bust hell wide open. You're going to lift your eyes up to hell. He did. So that's what John 3:16 said. God loved the whole entire world. It didn't have nothing to do with your color. Nope. No tribe. Nope. No culture. Nope.
Yes.
It has to do with your heart.
Yes.
And if your heart believes that God sent his son to redeem it, to redeem you, then guess what? He said, you're going to be saved.
Right.
You will not perish. You won't be lost.
Amen.
You won't be cut off. But you shall have everlasting life.
Amen.
And in verse 17, I love that, because if God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world,
yeah,
but that the word through him might be saved.
Yes.
God showed us that even in the story with the Shunammite woman and the son, he not only blessed her with what, and one thing that I understood, her husband was old, and if her husband died, she had nobody to help her,
yeah,
even if she survived the husband. So that's why God gave her that son, because she needed an heir, mm-hmm, to what she had.
Yes.
God blessed her so she could have, she didn't ask for it, she wasn't looking for it, but God blessed her with it because God knows what she needed.
Yes.
And because he knew what we needed, he knew we needed a son, so he sent his son, so that's why he sent
it.
He didn't send the sinner to condemn us.
Oh, yes.
He knew what sin would do to us. He knew what sin would cause us to die. He knew that sin was an everlasting death. He knew that the weight of sin, the wages, the payment was death, but the gift of God is eternal life. He knew this.
Yes.
And since he knew it, and he wrote it like that, he wanted us to receive. So the only way for us to receive it, we had to believe on the Son.
Jesus.
He loved us so much, and that his compassion failed not. And then Matthew 24:12 says this. And you know, I was thinking about why people don't show kindness today. You know, because back in the day, you can go next door and borrow a cup of sugar, and it wouldn't be no problem. Your neighbors were really your neighbors back then. You loved your neighbors. You actually wasn't scared to go talk to your neighbors. Nowadays, you don't know what them folks is doing next door. They don't make themselves, they don't act like they neighbors. They don't even want to be bothered with nobody. Don't look at them, because they don't look at you kind of crazy. You know, you don't know what if they packing or what they doing nowadays. These folks are living some reckless kind of life. But this is what Jesus says in Matthew 24:12. He said, and because of iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. That's why people ain't kind. They don't regard one another. They don't show the kindness. But they miss the whole thing. God so loved the whole world. He loved them before they even got to that point where they thought that they couldn't trust nobody, couldn't look at nobody, don't want you looking at them, and don't, you better not say nothing either. Because people got that attitude, that mentality. You say something to me, and I don't like it, I'm coming after you. They said it earlier, do unto you as you do unto them. And that is not even the golden rule. He said, do unto others as you would have. He said that they're going to treat you the way you want it to be treated.
Yes.
It didn't say that. But you got to treat people the way you desire to be loved. Love them in spite of themselves. So that is the reason he could say, for God so loved the world. He did. He said, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Yes.
We were yet sinners. We were yet still in our stuff, in our sin. Still doing what we did. And, you know, for that reason,
yeah,
you know, we in the 21st century, this is the way we are to project kindness.
Yeah.
Because the love of God didn't have to love us all.
Mm-hmm.
He knows, the word said, he's discerning the end from the beginning. the end from the beginning already know the whole story. He know what you're going to do. That's why Jeremiah could declare, he said, God declared this to Jeremiah, I know the plans and the thoughts I have towards you. Plans of good and not of evil. For peace that you might have an expected end. God already know your end, the end of the story.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
He knew the beginning.
Yes.
He was there from the beginning. So he know how it's going to end. Mm-hmm. But he gives you, because he gives you a free will. That's why it's to whosoever.
Mm-hmm.
You can receive this today or you can reject it.
Uh-huh.
Say you can either hear it or you can forget it.
Yeah.
You can receive it or you can just let it drop to the ground and like, okay, that wasn't for me.
Mm-hmm.
But I tell you today, if you miss this, you done missed it.
Yeah.
If you miss that out of the kindness and the one who compassion they will be renewed day by day. Love you even before you got here. Before you even know, before you messed up, before you all of that stuff.
Yes,
Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Even if you backslid, he still, because the word said he's married to the backslider. Yeah. And I mean, if you stay out there, no. But he still loves us in spite of ourselves. He loves us. No matter where we are, he loves us.
Amen.
The only thing he said he will not forgive is blasphemy. The Holy Spirit. And you better not commit suicide because he is called also the Spirit of Life. So that still would be blasphemy. The Holy Ghost.
Mm-hmm.
So, I thank God that even today, despite the fact that there is iniquity in the land and people are waxing colder and colder, but because of the kindness of the Lord's heart, his grace and his favor, unmerited.
Mm-hmm.
It really was undeserved. Oh, God,